Now, we've already seen a number of ozone alerts issued here in this country so far this summer. It's a health concern as ozone formation in the lower levels of the atmosphere can be harmful to people who experience respiratory problems. And the sizzling hot conditions that Korea has been under in recent weeks make the perfect environment for a high density of ozone. What to do when the air quality is subpar? Our Hwang Hojun reports.
Ozone pollution alerts have been issued for various regions across the country on Tuesday, including the capital area. According to Air Korea, a real-time weather forecast website, ozone levels reached bad for the Seoul metropolitan area, the west side of Gangwon-do province, the Chungcheong-do provinces, and Gyeongsangbuk-do province. This will mark the sixth ozone alert issued for Seoul since May of this year alone. The ozone layer is found in the stratosphere, approximately 10 kilometers above the Earth's surface in the mid-latitudes, and it protects us from the harmful radiation emitted by the sun. However, when volatile organic compounds such as vaporized gasoline and nitrogen oxides, which are emitted by automobiles and fossil fuel power plants, interact with strong UV rays from the sun, a light brown photochemical smog is created. This is known as ground-level or bad ozone. The generation of ground-level ozone is a common phenomenon during the summertime, especially in big industrialized cities such as Seoul or Los Angeles. This weather condition shouldn't be treated lightly as it can cause respiratory and cardiovascular diseases. When ozone levels are high, children and the elderly in particular are advised to avoid outdoor activities.
Ozone levels are usually high during a specific window of time and temperature, so extra precaution is needed from 1 p.m. to 5 p.m. when the temperature is around 26 degrees Celsius and above. You can go out in the morning or at night as ozone density isn't high then.
After a streak of dusty conditions blanketed the country during the spring months, Koreans are facing another weather-related headache, which experts are saying will continue until early fall. Hwang Hojun, Arirang News.